हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, फ्रॉम द टॉपिक मॉलिक्यूलर बेसिस ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस वी हैव स्टार्टेड द पॉइंट दैट इज द ट्रांसक्रिप्शन. सम पॉइंट वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस इन द लास्ट लेक्चर, बट इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट एंड दैट्स व्हाई दैट पॉइंट्स आई एम गोइंग टू रिपीट हियर अगेन एंड वील डिस्कस दिस ट्रांसक्रिप्शन इन डिटेल इन दिस लेक्चर. फ्रॉम दिस ट्रांसक्रिप्शन पॉइंट वी हैव टू discuss in detail that is the process of transcription. What is meant by transcription unit? Then we have to discuss transcription unit and particular gene which is responsible for that process of transcription. And the last point is the processing of hnRNA, that is heterogeneous nuclear RNA. So first, the transcription process, as some part we have discussed in previous lecture, but as it is very important part, those point I am going to repeat again here. That means the transcription process means the copying of information from one strand of the DNA into the RNA. That means the information from the one strand of the DNA get copy into the RNA strand, and that is called as the transcription. We have also discussed that this DNA is a double helical structure. That's why this double helical structure first gets separate from each other, and only one strand of the DNA is involved in the process of transcription. So only one strand take part in the process of transcription, not both the strands of DNA take part in the transcription. That point also we have discussed in the last lecture. Now what is new, or what point are new for us that we are going to discuss here? Those point are here, I am now discussing here. That is, as we know, the transcription, we have seen the definition of the transcription. Only one strand of DNA is involved in the process of transcription. Okay, now we have also seen that this transcription process occurs in the nucleus. Transcription process occur in the nucleus of the cell, and the translation process occur in the cytoplasm. But those part we are not discussing here. We focus only on this nucleus part, that is the transcription occur in the nucleus part of the cell. We have also seen that this transcription process generally takes place during the cell cycle in the G1 and the G2 phase. Transcription occur in the G1 and G2 phase of the cell cycle, but the middle stage, that is the S phase, which is particularly involved the replication of DNA. So in S phase, transcription do not occur. Transcription occur in G1 and the G2 phase, particularly in the eukaryotic cell, and it is occur in the nucleus. In the prokaryotic cell also, in the nucleus of the cell, there is a process which called as a transcription takes place. Okay, so nucleus of the prokaryotes and the nucleus of the eukaryotics are the region where the transcription process occur. So here again, I will write here, we are discussing the first process that we have called as the transcription, because in last lecture we have seen what is meant by central dogma. This central dogma was proposed by Crick. The Crick is the those of scientist who has with pair of the Watson discover the DNA model. So we call as the Watson and Crick discover the DNA model. From that pair, the Crick alone describe the central dogma. In the central dogma, we have seen that DNA form the mRNA, which we call as a transcription, and mRNA form the protein that we call as a translation. So that transcription part we are discussing now here, and here we have seen that how this transcription takes place in the nucleus of the cell. Only one strand of DNA is involved in that process. Transcription occur in both prokaryotic and eukaryotic, in the nuclei in prokaryotic and nucleus in the eukaryotic cell. In particular eukaryotic cells, transcription takes place in the G1 and the G2 phase, and in both prokaryotic as well as eukaryotic, the strand of DNA, suppose this is the strand of the DNA which form the RNA, okay, and the strand of DNA we have call it as a template DNA. We label it as a template DNA. That means the DNA which forms the RNA that strand of DNA we have called as a template DNA. And one important point here that this template DNA which form the RNA by the process of transcription, this template DNA should have two important parts. One part which is present at the starting of this DNA is called as the promoter region. And one part which is present at the end of this DNA which is called as the terminator region. This promoter initiates the process of transcription, while this terminator terminate, stop the process of transcription. So every DNA, maybe the prokaryotic or the eukaryotic, which are going to form the RNA, it should have promoter region at the starting of that DNA, which start the process of transcription, and it should have terminator region at the end of the DNA, which terminate or stop the process of the transcription. So these two regions are very important, and we should be present on that template DNA which are going to involve in the process of mRNA formation. And in both prokaryotic as well as in eukaryotic, this process of transcription takes place by the three process, and those processes are, we have also discussed in the last lecture, that both prokaryotes and eukaryotes process of transcription involves three processes, and those are the initiation. Second one is the elongation, and third one is the termination. See here, initiation means start. When, just we have seen that when the promoter region start the RNA formation, then it is called as the initiation process. For formation of the new RNA, new ribonucleoside should be present in the nucleoplasm, that should be collected, and new RNA strand is formed, that is called as the elongation of that RNA. And at the end, process gets stopped at the region of termination, and that is called as the termination. So if the question is asked for MCQ, arrange the processes of or the sequence of the processes in the mRNA formation in both prokaryotes and eukaryotes, then we have to write first process is initiation, where the mRNA synthesis starts. Second is the elongation, where that mRNA strand get elongated, get longer in length due to the attraction or due to the collection of the different ribonucleoside from the nucleoplasm. And second one is the termination, that means that process gets stopped, terminate, and the newly formed mRNA gets separated from that template DNA. That process is called as the termination. So both are prokaryotic and eukaryotes. This is the same sequence you will find: initiation, elongation, and termination. Here we have completed the first part that we have called as a transcription. Then the second important part is that the transcription unit. The transcription unit. This definition also we have seen in the last lecture. That is, I have told you that generally for the board exam, for one sentence question, the definition is asked, that is, what is mean by transcription unit. So what is mean by transcription unit? I have told you the definition, that the DNA fragment which get transcribed, the DNA fragment which get transcribed is called the transcription unit. In other words, we can say that this is the DNA, okay, this is the DNA which we have labeled as the template DNA, which we have labeled as the template DNA. This is the DNA which we have labeled as the template DNA. In another word, we say that it is the transcribed fragment of DNA, and this transcribed fragment of DNA is called as the transcription unit, because this DNA later on form the new mRNA strand, and that's why it is called as the transcription unit or the transcribed fragment of DNA. Okay, you should clear first the concept, that is, what is mean by transcription unit. The template DNA is also called as the transcription unit. or in other words, the definition of the transcription unit is that the transcribed segment of DNA means the one strand of DNA that are going to form the mRNA strand is called as the transcribed segment of DNA. That is the definition of the transcription unit. And in this transcribed segment of DNA that we also call as the template DNA, they told us that or we have just seen here has the three important component. That means that transcribed segment of DNA or that transcription unit should have three important part, and those are first, just we have seen that is the here I will write only P stands for the promoter. At the end, another sequence of the gene is there. I have labeled it as a T, that is the terminator. And in between this two region, there are some genes are present which we have called as a structural genes. So another question is asked from this point that what is the important components of the transcription unit, or which are the important components of the transcription unit? The important component of the transcription unit are three, and those are the promoter, terminator and the structural gene. Okay, those are the promoter, structural gene and the terminator. These are the three important components of the transcription unit, and that are present in or on the template DNA or the transcribed segment of DNA. Okay, now here one more important point that we are going to discuss, that is what is mean by template strand. Another name of the template strand is the antisense strand. As in the structure of DNA or in the replication of DNA, we have seen that the DNA strand is always double stranded. The two strands are present and which are helically coiled around each other. So generally DNA is not in a single stranded form, it is always in the double stranded form. So first thing is that during the process of transcription, this double stranded DNA should be separated out. And out of this two strand, one strand is involved in the process of the transcription. So we should know the names of the template DNA or the another name of the template DNA, and the strand of the DNA which is separated from the template DNA or which is not actually taking part in the process of transcription, the name of that strand is called as a coding strand or the sense strand. So here we clear first the concept of what is meant by coding strand and non-coding strand or sense strand and the antisense strand. Then we will see how this non-coding or the sense strand are involved as a reference strand. So this figure that I am going to draw here is very very important to understand the point of the reference strand or the non-coding strand. So here, as we know, there are the two strands of the DNA. Okay, one strand run as 5' to 3', and other strand which is antiparallel runs as the 3' to 5'. Okay, so these are the two strands which are antiparallel because opposite ends of this DNA come close to each other. Then what happened here? We have to see that the strand which always run 3' to 5'. I am writing here the strand which is always run 3' to 5', that strand is called as the template strand. This strand is called as the template strand. And in this figure, which is the template strand? This is the template strand. So we'll label it as the template strand. Okay, the strand which run as 5' to 3'. Here I will write 5' to 3'. The strand which run as 5' to 3' is called as the coding strand. It is called as the coding strand. So in figure here we'll label it as the coding strand. It is the coding strand. Okay, so two strands. Question is always asked like that, in which direction template strand runs, or in other words we say that what is the polarity of the template strand. So template strand always has polarity 3' to 5'. and the polarity of the coding strand is called as 5' to 3'. Now we'll discuss in detail why it is template strand and why it is the coding strand. Okay, now we'll see that just we have seen that at initial site of the DNA there is a sequence that we have called as a promoter. At the end of the DNA we have seen this sequence that is called as terminator. While in between this promoter and terminator there are the structural genes. Okay. Now another question is asked here that in which region of the DNA promoter is present and in which region of the DNA terminator is present. Here I have told you that only this strand of the DNA is involved in the process of transcription. This another strand we have labeled as the coding strand, which runs 5' to 3', is not involved in the process of transcription. But here this strand which we have labeled as a coding strand, which runs 5' to 3', is called as a reference strand. Which only gives the reference of where the promoter get attached or where the terminator get attached, but it is not actually taking part in the process of transcription. That means if the question is asked that where the promoter region is present on the DNA, some student may say that the promoter region is present on the 3' end of the DNA, because you know that template DNA taking part in the transcription. So definitely some student will give the answer that this promoter region is present at the 3' end and the terminal region is present at the 5' end, but that answer is wrong, because the reference for that promoter and the terminator is of this coding strand. So the question is asked that where the promoter region is attached to the DNA strand, then answer will be at the 5' end, or where the terminator region is attached, then answer will be the 3' end, because these are the reference strand which give the references where this promoter and the RNA strand are, where the promoter and the terminator is attached. But other than it, it do not have any role in the process of transcription. Okay, so it is very very important that the promoter get attached to the 5' end of the DNA and the terminator get attached to the 3' end of the DNA, of which these ends are of the coding strand DNA. But actually the template strand will be involved in the process of transcription. Okay, these are the some of the important points. But here we should know also what is mean by sense strand and what is mean by antisense strand. So here you should know that this coding strand is also called as the sense strand. And this template strand is also called as non-coding or antisense strand. Okay, what is the meaning of the non-coding? So if coding strand is 5' to 3', then what is the non-coding strand? 3' to 5'. If the 5' to 3' is the sense strand, then 3' to 5' is the antisense strand. The one important trick is that how you should keep in mind these things. These are that you only focus on the one strand. That is 3' to 5' strand is called a template strand. It is also called as a non-coding strand. It is also called as an antisense strand. Then immediately opposite to it, 5' to 3' is coding strand, sense strand. Okay, so these are the difference. So you have to focus on only one strand. Opposite to that, there will be names of the other strand. So I think you will get clear cut idea about what is coding, what is non-coding, what is the reference point, or which strand is considered as a reference point. That strand is called as a 5 prime to 3 prime strand, or which we also call as the coding strand. Okay, these are some of the important points. Now, one statement is which is very, very important for the MCQ point of view, and that I am going to write here. What I say that I am going to write here, concentrate it, because the same statement we'll see by drawing the figure. So which is that statement? And that statement is very important because number of questions for the NEET exam are based on the statement. And what is that statement? The statements are the sequence of template DNA is complementary to coding DNA. Okay, it is very easy. I will write here 5 prime to 3 prime, one strand that we call as a coding strand. Here, other strand 3 prime to 5 prime, that is the which region? Template DNA. Now here what I have written, sequence of the template DNA is complementary to coding DNA. So here if this has sequence A, T, C, G, then complementary sequence will be A pairs with T, T pairs with A, C pairs with G, G pairs with C. This we call as a complementary sequence. So it is clear that the sequence of the coding DNA is complementary to the template DNA. This is the one statement that you are well known about it, because this process we have seen in the replication of the DNA. But the another important statement is that is sequence of coding strand is similar to mRNA. See here, sequence of coding strand. Coding means the strand which are not involved in the process of transcription, which always run 5 prime to 3 prime, is similar to mRNA. Instead of that, there will be one single difference, and that difference I will write in the bracket. That is, instead, or we say that thymine get replaced by uracil. Only difference is that on the coding strand, if there is a thymine on the mRNA, instead of that thymine there will be uracil. Because I will repeat here that in the DNA strand, or on the DNA strand, 4 nitrogen bases are present. I have told you already this in the previous lecture, but here I will repeat again, because we have to know clear cut which are the base sequence on the DNA and which are the base sequence on the RNA. So on DNA, adenine, thymine, guanine and cytosine are present. Adenine, thymine, guanine and cytosine are present. And on RNA, adenine. But instead of thymine, there will be uracil. Guanine is same, cytosine is same. So every student should be known to this fact that there is a little difference, that on DNA thymine is present, and instead of that thymine on RNA uracil is present. So the statement says that sequence of coding strand is similar to mRNA. mRNA means which strand is from this mRNA? Template strand. That means from the template strand that mRNA form, but that mRNA sequence is very similar to not the template strand, but to the coding strand. And the one difference is that on coding strand, thymine will be present because it is a DNA strand. and on the mRNA instead of the thymine uracilase version because it is a RNA strand. I think you have a great clear cut idea about it. That's why I have repeated the same points again in this lecture, due to which you can get clear cut idea of the process of transcription, because this point is very interesting one. But some students do not understand it easily. That's why I am repeating the number of points again in this lecture, due to which you can get clear cut idea about it. So this is the point where we are explaining the statement how the coding strand sequence is similar to the mRNA. Now here I will draw one of the figure, and by which you will get idea the coding strand sequence, how it looks similar to the newly formed mRNA from the template DNA. So here I'm going to draw three figures. See here, this one is strand, that is a 5'-3'. Always keep in mind that the mRNA strand in the RNA structure we will study in detail, but here you should know that mRNA strand always run 5'-3'. RNAs are always single stranded, they are not double stranded like the DNA. So in the mRNA the strand runs as the 5'-3', and see the sequence of mRNA: A, C, G. Just I have told you that the thymine is not present in the RNA, instead of that there will be uracil. So here we will write U, again C, U, okay. Any sequence you can take here. I have taken this UU at the 2 point because I have to show you that how uracil is represented by thymine in the DNA. This strand, we label it as mRNA. Okay, I am again repeating the same sentence that mRNA strand is always single stranded, is run as a 5'-3'. Okay, now I will draw another strand. It will be 3'-5'. And the sequence on the strands are here, I'll write it is as a template. And one strand is there, which we are going to label as 5'-3'. These are the coding DNA. These are the coding DNA. Okay, so what is the, I will write the sequence of coding DNA: A, C, G, T, G, T. Okay. As we told that DNA, this template DNA, coding DNA are the complementary DNA. Okay. So as they are both complementary to each other, how original they are present like this. And if A is there, here should be T. If C is there, here should be G. If G is there, here should be C. If T is there, here should be A. If G is there, here is C. And if T is there, here is A. So these are the complementary base pairing. One strand run as a 3'-5', or the strand run as a 5'-3'. These are the two double helical strand of DNA which has a complementary base pairing, because in last lecture we have shown that in between A and T there is a double hydrogen bond, in between G and C there is a triple hydrogen bond, in between C and G there is a triple hydrogen bond, in between A and T there is a double hydrogen bond, in between C and G there is a triple hydrogen bond, and in between A and T there is a double hydrogen bond. These are the bonds which maintain the two helical DNA strand together, and these are the weak hydrogen bond. When we have to break that DNA, we have to break this weak hydrogen bond, and then only we can separate this double stranded DNA from each other, that we have seen in the replication of the DNA. Now, what I am going to tell you here that the template DNA and coding DNA are the complementary DNA, so the base pair is a complementary to each other. But one statement just I have given here that the coding DNA has a sequence which is similar to the mRNA. Coding DNA has a sequence which is similar to mRNA. Instead of that, one difference is there. In coding DNA, thymine is present and that is replaced by uracil in mRNA. And that now we are going to check here. That is, we have to focus only on these two strands. One is called as the coding strand and another strand is called as the mRNA strand. Here we will not focus on this strand because our statement is that the sequence of coding strand is similar to the mRNA strand. So we'll check here. Here is adenine, here is also adenine. Here is cytosine, cytosine. Guanine, guanine. Thymine, but we are told that instead of thymine, uracil is present, so uracil. Guanine, what is here? Sorry, cytosine, and thymine is there, here is uracil. See again, sequence of coding strand and the sequence of mRNA is very, very similar. Okay, it is very important because the MCQ questions are only asked on this coding sequence and the mRNA sequence because number of students cannot understand the meaning of coding and the mRNA strand. Even though this mRNA is formed from the template DNA, no doubt, but the sequence of the mRNA and the sequence of the coding strand is similar because the coding strand is complementary to a template DNA. And that's why coding strand has a similar sequence to that of the mRNA because this mRNA is going to form from this template DNA. So all about this is about the point that we are discussing in the transcription unit. Now, the important point that is same from this transcription unit is that in the diagram, we have seen that this template DNA or the transcribed segment of DNA should have the transcription unit. And in that transcription unit, the three important parts will be there. Those parts are promoter, terminator, and the structural gene. So, first part, that one, or that is the promoter. As we are told that this promoter is present at 5 prime end of DNA. Here we are just saying that DNA, but you should know this is the DNA of the reference, that is the coding strand of DNA. So this point is very, very important where this promoter is present. It is present at the 5 prime end of DNA of the reference strand. Second one, what is the role of this promoter? This promoter to which or at the site of promoter RNA polymerase, in short I write POLY, RNA polymerase bind. So second important thing is that on the promoter region the enzyme of RNA from the DNA and the name of that enzyme is RNA polymerase. So this RNA polymerase enzyme bind to the promoter site. Where it is bind? It is bind to the promoter site. Second point, In prokaryotes, the RNA polymerase enzyme identifies this promoter by the sigma factor. So in prokaryotes, sigma factor identify promoter region. It is also very important point. That is, for MCQ, question will be asked that in which animals or in which organism the sigma factor identifies the promoter region. The answer is that in prokaryotes. In prokaryotes, the promoter region is identified by sigma factor of that RNA polymerase, and due to which RNA polymerase can easily bind on the promoter region. So, these are the important points of the promoter present at the 5 prime end of DNA. RNA polymerase bind on this promoter region. In prokaryotic, sigma factor is responsible for identifying the promoter region and it helps to the RNA polymerase And thus, these are the important points of the promoter. Now, second point that we are going to discuss is the structural gene, because we all know that promoter structural genes and determinator, these are the three important points. So, second point is structural gene. Now, this point that I am going to discuss here, focus clearly on this point, because somewhat different theory of it is given in the our state board, and number of students cannot identify this, because structural genes means the actual genes which get transcribed from DNA to mRNA. Actual genes which get transcribed from DNA to RNA are called as the structural genes. But in that point, in the textbook, the theory is given different. So you should know what is meant by structural gene. That point I am writing here, structural genes means gene which get transcribed or copied from one strand of DNA to RNA transcript. I have told you the meaning of RNA transcript, that means the RNA which are formed from the one of the strand of the DNA is called as the RNA transcript, or in simple word we say that as the RNA. So structural genes, this point is not clearly given in the theory. So I have told you that structural genes mean the genes which are present on the DNA are actually copied or transcribed into this RNA, that is called as the RNA transcript. But in that point, the points which are discussed in our textbook, that the same point I am going to discuss here, because number of students get confused that in textbooks the theory is given different and I am giving you the different theory. So you should match the theory as well as our lecture. So for that point of view, I am discussing here that structural genes madhe काय सांगितले आहे बघा आपल्याला इथे तुम्हाला सांगितले आहे 5' to 3' is the one strand. That strand we are called as a coding strand, or another name of it as a sense strand. Another strand 3' to 5' is the template DNA or non-coding DNA. Or the antisense strand. In this point, they are given that the two strands which has opposite polarity get involved in the process of transcription. But actual strand involved is the template DNA. This coding strand acts as a reference strand, and they are given the same diagram here. That is here at the 5' end, terminator attached at the 3' end of the reference strand. Here promoter is attached at 5' and 3' end, there is would be terminator attached, and in between these two there are the structural genes. The same figure is given here, and same point are discussed in the structural genes. But only one point you should know in between the structural genes, that those genes are present on DNA and they get transcribed on the RNA. And the last part of it, of the transcription unit, and it is the terminator. We told that this terminator region is attached at 5' end of the coding strand or the reference strand. When this RNA polymerase first attached to the promoter region, then it goes through the whole DNA, that means the template DNA, and finally that RNA polymerase comes to the terminator region, which is attached at the 3' end. Where it is attached? It is attached at the 3' end, because at 5' end there will be attachment of the promoter, and at 3 prime end there will be attachment of the terminator. So terminator is attached at the 3 prime end. When RNA polymerase bind here at the 5 prime end, then slowly it goes and at the end, that is called as the terminator region. And at that terminator region, here the process of transcription stops. So important point that transcription stops at terminator region. The newly formed mRNA fall off or detach from the template DNA. Suppose here this newly formed DNA is there. Sorry, I am repeating sentence. This newly formed mRNA, when terminator is here, this newly formed mRNA gets separated or fall off from the template DNA and process of transcription stops. So two points are very important. Terminator is present at 3 prime end. Transcription process stops at the terminator region. So these three points are very important, which are the important part of the transcription unit, that is the promoter, structural gene and the terminator. See here what happened after the termination of the process of transcription, after the follow-up of newly formed mRNA. What happened? These two strands of the DNA, one is called as the template DNA and its complementary strand is called as the coding strand, they again get coiled to each other. So which structure you will find here? See here, we will see the same structure here. After completion of the process of the transcription, what happened? The strands of the DNA, one is template, other is coding, again get coiled with each other because process of transcription gets stopped. Newly mRNA form is there, and then that both DNA again coil around each other. Okay, one strand run as 5 prime and other run as 3 prime. So such a anti-parallel opposite end structure is formed here after completion of the process of this transcription. So in today's lecture, we have just completed only two points. One is of the transcription and another is of the transcription unit, because just I have told you that this transcription process is very important, and that's why the transcription and which points are very important from today's lecture. Again, I will revise in few points, that is the definition of the transcription is important for theory point of view. Definition of the transcription unit is important for the theory point of view. And for MCQ point of view, you should know the reference strand, that is the coding strand, that is the sense strand, and the template DNA, that is the non-coding strand and the antisense strand. The actual strand which is involved in the process of transcription is the template strand, but the coding strand is only required as a reference strand. It do not have actual role in the process of transcription. Another important point is that means the sequence of the coding strand is very similar to newly formed mRNA strand. Instead of that, one difference is there, instead of thymine of the coding strand get replaced by uracil on the mRNA strand. This is the major difference. And the template DNA and the coding strand are the complementary to each other, because they are the part of the one DNA. Only two strands of it is the template DNA and the coding strand. Then next point is that promoter, structural gene and the terminator region, these are the three important parts of the transcription unit, which should be present on the template DNA. And for that template DNA, one strand get attached, that is called as a coding strand, which is involved as a reference point. So promoter is that region of the DNA which is attached to the 5 prime end, where the RNA polymerase enzyme bind and carry out the process of transcription. In prokaryotic, the RNA polymerase enzyme identify the promoter by the sigma factor. Structural gene means actually the genes on the DNA which get transcribed or copied on mRNA. In the structure gene, we have seen that how the 5 prime to 3 prime and 3 prime to 5 prime strands run, and there will be the reference and the actual template DNA. And in the third one, we have seen that the terminator region is present at the 3 prime end, which is actually involved in the stop of the process of the transcription. When this RNA polymerase at last reach to the terminator region, it stop the process of the transcription. That's why we call it as a terminator region, and it is present at the 3 prime end. After the completion of the transcription, or when the RNA polymerase reach to the terminator region, the newly formed mRNA strand separate from the template DNA, it get follow, and we say that the process of transcription get completed. Here the one more important point is that after formation of mRNA, the two strands of DNA again coil around each other and make the structure like the double helical DNA. So these two points are very, very important. In the next lecture, we are going to study the transcription unit and gene. That means we have to see that which are actually genes are get transcribed from DNA to mRNA. Some are called as a coding sequence of DNA, some are called as a non-coding sequence of DNA. In the same way, we have to see that on the DNA strands, on the DNA strand, there are some monocystronic gene and some polycystronic gene, because we should know that on the DNA, the three important parts are there, that is the cistron, recon and mutron. And the cistron is those part of the DNA which is actually involved in the process of the transcription. So here we have completed two important points, transcription and transcription unit. In the next lecture, we'll see how this mRNA, which is formed from the DNA, get processed, because in prokaryotics, just after formation of mRNA from the DNA, this mRNA immediately get functional, get involved in the process of protein synthesis. But in eukaryotic cell or in the eukaryotic organism, the mRNA which is formed from the DNA is non-functional. It is non-functional. That mRNA should be processed, and after processing of that mRNA become functional and it will take part in the process of transcription. Okay, thank you.